Your competition already put in the hard work of finding profitable products for their Amazon FBA business. So, why not search the internet for these products? If you're interested in doing this type of search, but you don't want to do it manually, then you will definitely want to hear how Tactical Arbitrage's reverse search function can help you search through over 1,000 online retailers for your competition's product. This is an amazing way to grow your Amazon FBA business, and in this video, we'll dive deep into it. If you're new here, my name is Tom with Path to Billions, and on this channel, I'm documenting my financial journey and taking you along for the journey so we could succeed together. My channel is currently focused on Amazon FBA, and this video is the second of three that I'm doing all about tactical arbitrage and how to use it for your business. Don't forget to subscribe if you're interested in starting or growing an Amazon FBA business. If you didn't watch the last video, then I'll have it linked down in the description in case you want to watch that one first. If you did miss that one, then I would just like to reiterate that Tactical Arbitrage is an online tool that helps you scan over 1,000 online retailers for profitable products for your Amazon FBA business. As you can see right here, online arbitrage costs $70 a month if billed annually. And if you are billed monthly, you can see it costs $89 a month. In the last video, we went over product search, and in this video, we are going to be going over reverse search. The difference between the two is that product search is scanning a specific online retailer, say Target, and then searching those products on Amazon to see if there's any profitable products. In a reverse search, we are doing the reverse. We are taking Amazon and searching those listings across all 1,000 plus retailers that Tactical Arbitrage has in its database to see if you can purchase those products at a low enough price to make a profit on if you then sell it on Amazon. This means we are going to be starting our search on Amazon in order to find products to scan through those 1,000 plus retailers. But first, we'll go through reverse search on Tactical Arbitrage to show you the filters and features so you know how to set it up for when you scan lists. If you did watch the last video, then you may have seen some of these features and filters before, but I am going to go through it all. So the first feature we have is set cache. And if you click this drop down here, you can see you have anywhere from live only to 5 days. This is a feature that balances accuracy with speed. If you set your search to live only, you are searching through the retailers with current stock levels and any current sale prices. Whereas if you switch this to 5 days, you are searching those same retailers but from 5 days ago. So live only is going to be the most accurate because it is showing current stock levels and current prices, whereas 5 days would be a faster search but less accurate. For me, with reverse search, I tend to keep it at 1 day. I don't want to get a ton of results that are now out of stock. When I do product searches, I keep it at about 3 days. Next, we have also show title and image matches. What this does is instead of just looking simply for UPCs and matching those up, Tactical Arbitrage will go through and do image match searches and title match searches. So it'll take the title from the Amazon listing and then search it through their online retailers. And it'll also take images it finds and searches those through its online catalog. And if you have any questions about what these features do while you're on Tactical Arbitrage, you can always click this little question mark box next to the feature. It'll bring up a little text box that gives you more information. Similar to a lot of these different features and filters, a lot of this is balancing speed and accuracy. If you start searching for images and titles, you are going to get possibly less accurate results because the UPCs won't match. But keep in mind, Amazon doesn't always have 100% correct UPCs. This is something I've run into a lot with Amazon. Next, we have the feature to filter down from USA websites, and we are selling on Amazon's US website. If you are selling in any other country or sourcing from any other country, you could just pick which one you want to do. Next, we have import bulk codes. With this feature, you are uploading a file with ASINs and UPCs, and then reverse search will take those and search through their retailers. Next, we have quick search, single or up to 100 ASINs, UPCs, or ISBNs. And this is the same feature as import bulk, but import bulk, you could do more than 100. Next, we have quick keyword search, which is something I don't use. You have use save filters and name a search. Next up, we have filter products. So we'll scroll down, and the first one we have is store price adjustments. So you can see I don't have any of these filled out here. And the reason is if we go over here as percent discounts, it pulls up a separate window. And you could see, you could actually go to every individual website on their system and put in manual percentages depending on whether you could get gift cards, cash back, or a discount percentage from that store. You can see I set my base sales tax for all the websites at 6.625% because that's what I pay in my state. Now for me, I don't go through and find whether I could get gift cards from all these or whether I get discounts from all these. I simply go to the main stores I usually shop on and try and keep those ones up to date. Once you fill out all this information, you go up here and hit save. And then that will always be there whenever you do reverse search. So if you notice a store that you normally do searches on has a sale, you go in there and update it for your current reverse searches. We will collapse this one and go to the next, which is remove. And this has a ton of different features that you could play with to narrow down your results that you get. The only one I use is sales ranks. And you can see here, I don't actually fill out all the sales ranks because I don't sell in most of these categories. And most of these are just broad numbers that are based off of what I've personally bought and sold in the past. For sales ranks, you will have to determine what's best for your business. If you're newer to Amazon, you want to have quick turnover, you're going to want to set these lower than if you are farther on in your Amazon business and you're willing to wait longer for more profit. But you could set these all manually depending on your own personal preference, and then you would hit save as well. Then we can collapse this and go on the next one, which is cost and fees. This one is mainly for if you're using a prep center. So you can put your cost to prep per standard product, per oversized product to create a bundle. And then this is the one you want to fill in, which I estimate mine at about 60 cents per pound. If you are newer to Amazon, you want to put it a little higher because the less items you send in, the more it's going to cost per pound. So we'll collapse this one. Then next we have profit and ROI. If you did watch my last video, you'll see these numbers are slightly different than they were on my product search. No particular reason for that, but for gross profit, I keep it at 215. For me, I don't buy a product if it doesn't have more than $2.25 in profit, and I set this a little bit lower because tactical arbitrages, price that it gives you may not be 100% accurate, so I like to give myself a little cushion so I don't miss any potential products. Next, we have gross ROI, which is, I keep at 30%. For me, I'm not buying anything less than 40% ROI. But I do keep it there for a little bit of cushion just in case the prices aren't 100% accurate. Collapse that. And then you have out of stock filters, which is another thing I don't personally use. So we will collapse that. Now that you got all your filters set up, so when you search a list, you're getting the best possible results for your business, you need to pull that list. And there are three main ways to get that list, and I use one tool for that. So we'll start our search on Amazon and go from there. So when you're on the Amazon homepage, all you gotta do is search something. I'm gonna search action figures. And now you have a bunch of products pulled up on this page. When I first started doing this, I was originally using a free tool called ASIN Grabber Lite, which you can see here. Unfortunately, it looks like since I stopped using them, they went the way of Keepa and started making their service a subscription only, so you can no longer use the free version of it. However, I personally now use Storefront Stalker, which you can see here, and you can right click. Hit all ASINs from the seller and page, and then it'll pull up all seven pages that Amazon returns you as search results. Then you go over here to TA for tactical arbitrage, unclick general. Then I always name the file based on what I'm searching. So for this one, I'll just do action figures and hit save, close out of this. For this first method, there are limitless possibilities of what you could search on Amazon, which means there's limitless possibilities on the list you could pull to search through reverse search. If you're currently selling a certain brand, you can search that brand and pull up all their products on Amazon and then search those products. If you currently sell a certain type of product, like action figures, you could search that. Or if you just want to go with a broad search, you could search almost anything on here. So definitely experiment with this and then see what gives you the best results. For a second method, we are going to go into one of these listings real quick. I'll click this one. Then we'll go over here to new and used options, click that, and it'll pull up all the sellers on this listing. What you want to do is look for a seller with a large amount of reviews, which indicates they have a large amount of items in stock on their store. So you can see this first one here, Deep Discount Entertainment, has over 500,000 reviews. So we'll click the seller name to get to their store, then you just click their storefront, and again, it pulls up a huge list of products. So you go over to Storefront Stalker Pro. Right click on it and hit all ASINs from the seller page. You could see Storefront Stalker Pro caps out at 150 pages, but that is plenty of results for you to search. Keep in mind with this method, it doesn't matter whether the seller buys via wholesale, retail arbitrage, or online arbitrage. You are essentially trying to pull a list that has a diverse selection of products for you to be able to go and then reverse search and see if you can find those same products. Again, we are clicking TA, unclicking general, and then I name it the store name and then hitting save. My big tip for method number two is to keep a list of the sellers you're searching and what type of results you get. I personally have a sheet that tells me the seller, gives me a link to their storefront, tells me last time I scanned them, and rough idea of how many items I actually bought based on that search. Then I go back to that list every once in a while, see how long it's been since I scanned that store, and then scan it again. This way, you don't even have to go through the effort of finding new sellers. You could just keep refreshing through the list you have. So I close this. Now, for the third method, you want to go over here to the best sellers. Then you click on any category you want to search through. So we'll go to toys and games. So this is the top 100 products in the toys and games category. Keep in mind, number one is going to be selling so fast. So if you can find any of these products and have a profit margin on them, you will sell these so quickly once they get into Amazon. And again, you go to Storefront Stalker Pro, right click, and hit all ASINs from this seller page. Then you just do TA, unclick general, and you could do top 100 toys and hit save. I would say method number three is the one I use the least, simply because the top products in any given category are most likely going to be selling by Amazon or selling by high quality wholesalers who get really good prices, and it'll be hard to beat them. Method number two is definitely my favorite because you are finding products that you wouldn't normally search for. And searching through 150 pages of somebody's store is a lot of items to be searching through. We are back on tactical arbitrage and we already have our filter set up. So when we search through those lists we pulled, we'll find the best possible products for our businesses. The next step is to import those lists into tactical arbitrage. So you want to go over here to the feature that says import bulk product codes, click that and upload new file. Then you're going to go over here to choose file and you can see we selected action figures. You can then hit upload and you'll see Storefront Stalker Pro pulls the UPC and the ASIN. So you hit upload. Now, all you do is hit search. You can see your search is in progress. It is then going through its 1,000 plus online retailers and seeing if it could find those products. If it does find that product, it'll then take the price from that retailer and then it'll apply any discounts that you might get and it will add any fees that you're paying. So for instance, the 60 cents per pound that you're paying to ship to Amazon. It will then see if there's any profit margin in that product and if the profit margin meets your minimum requirements. Once the search is done, you still have to go over to Search Manager and manually search through the results it gives you, even though you narrowed them down, and make sure each product is actually as good as it seems on Tactical Arbitrage. There's things like searching through the sales history, making sure the pricing is accurate, making sure you're on gated, and other things that you have to do to make sure you're buying with confidence. Now, if you want to know how to buy in confidence, the third video in this mini series I had mentioned earlier is going to be diving deep into the search results from our searches. So if you want to watch that, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications because I am going to be posting that video next. Also, if you like this video, then make sure you give this video a like. It is always appreciated. Don't forget to leave a comment if you have any questions, and thanks for watching.